In this video, we're going to talk about the video head impulse test, which is one of several kinds of vestibular tests your doctor may recommend. If you haven't seen it already, the video introducing how vestibular physiology works will make the video head impulse test easier to understand. During the video head impulse test, you'll be asked to focus your eyes on a target while your head is put through a series of quick rotations, and a high-speed camera will be used to track your eye movements. Specifically, it'll be used to determine whether your eyes stay focused on the target. Why measure the eye movements? One of the important functions of the vestibular system is called the vestibulo-ocular reflex. When the vestibular system senses head motion, this reflex causes the eyes to move in their sockets to compensate for the motion, which allows them to smoothly stay focused on a stationary object. If the vestibular system isn't able to sense the rotation, the eyes will drift away from the target, and then after a short delay, the brain realizes the shift in the image and then refocuses back on the object. A video head impulse test can provide information about the functioning of all six semicircular canals, which are the parts of the inner ear that work together to sense head rotations in any direction. It's important to know ahead of time that vestibular testing can be uncomfortable. There aren't any long-term effects, but it's not unusual to feel fatigued or slightly unsteady after the test, and depending on the cause of your symptoms, the test could cause motion sickness or nausea. And finally, as with any vestibular test, it's important to keep in mind that the test is only one piece of the puzzle. Your doctor will work with you to combine the information from the test and your symptoms and medical history to determine the best course of treatment. That's it for this video. You can find more information on the UCSF Balance and Falls Center website. Thanks for watching.